Hi guys. Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, as you guys would have guessed by the title, we are doing something a little bit different. Yes, we are. We're doing something that we haven't done on this channel before. We are doing a haul. This isn't a typical haul, number one. This is actually a product-based haul, but you guys need to see this bag. So, this is the bag of stuff. And as you guys can see, it's really full. There's a few things that I've kind of picked up over the last few months/weeks. Some of them I have used, some of them I haven't used. But I just thought to myself, it would be quite cool for me to show you guys what I usually get. No, not what I usually get. Show you guys what I've got, what I've picked up. Yeah, I just thought it would be quite cute. So I'm gonna split it into two because the main things are skincare and makeup. I have like other accessories and stuff. I don't know what to start with. Should I start with makeup or should I start with skincare? Let's start with makeup. This face was beat by a lot of the products that are actually in this bag. I picked up a lot of makeup in my most recent shops. What we're gonna do, we're gonna jump straight into the video. The first item of makeup that I'm about to show you guys is, drum roll please, guys, this foundation. And I'm not just saying it because I want it, I'm saying it because I've tried it. Like, can you see my skin right now? Can you see what I'm wearing right now? Can you see what it's doing right now? It's the Too Faced Born This Way Matte Foundation in the shade Cocoa. So it wasn't closed. Anyway, it looks like this. It comes in a matte textured bottle, and it has a black lid and it's got a pump. This is the 24-hour undetectable super long wear foundation. As you guys know, I have the oily skin, so I don't believe in anything dewy, anything that isn't oil free. Just move it from me, because this one even says oil free, oil controlling, waterproof, transfer resistant. Do you know what that means? This is from God himself. So this is what I'm wearing today, and guys, I can't lie to you, 10 out of 10. Absolute 10 out of 10. And without further ado, if I introduce the mother, I have to introduce the daughter. So this is the Born This Way Super Coverage Multi-Use Sculpting Concealer. So you can use it to conceal, contour, highlight and retouch in the shade Chestnut. Again, I can't lie to you guys, these Too Faced products, out of this world. Again, you've got the matte fill bottle and you've got the shiny black lid, but with this one it's a screw top and you've got an applicator brush, like so. The richness, and this is what I was trying to say in the other video when I filmed it, the richness of these shades is insane. I can't lie, it's insane. Like, not even in a way of, oh yeah, I'm just saying it, because no. And these two products, they complement each other so well. I've used products from the same brands that I can use one and the second product will be sliding off. That doesn't happen with this. Like, these two work in harmony. They're harmonious. They're not fighting each other. They know that one has to be on the bottom, one has to be on the top. They're actually the best makeup products that I've tried this year. And I know that they're not new. I know that they're not new, so I'm late to the game. But I'm even happy that I'm late to the game, because I let everybody else try it. I saw the reviews. I saw you guys wear it. I saw you guys, you know, do your thing with it. And I can't lie to you, I respect y'all. But as for me, I had to take time. Guys, I'm a creature of habit. L'Oreal, that was working for me, completely fine. My Maybelline, that was working for me, completely fine. But then something just says this. Let's do better. I haven't been the best year, but you know, you can wear makeup that will just make you feel, you know, just making you to feel great. Lo and behold, that is what we have with those products. Next, I am going on to my older sister. She's had this makeup line for a while, and I can't lie, she doesn't disappoint. I have the Fenty Beauty by Rihanna Sunstalker Instant Warmth Bronzer in the shade Mocha Mami. What I'm gonna do, guys, is show you by fire, by force, that my camera must focus, because it's not mad when the camera is not mad. So this is the packaging. Can you see that? Are we understanding that? Can you see how good that looks? And then on the back, you've got your name, Mocha Mami. But what I need you guys to see is the richness. And I'm so sorry. If the makeup that I'm buying isn't this rich, I don't want it. Keep it. I don't want it. I know it might look a little looked a little bit washed out, but aim is for you guys to see the richness in the color. Beautiful bronze, as in, and when I say there's nobody who will use, oh, hey, hey sis, hey babe. There's nobody who will use this color. And when I'm speaking from the, what's the word I'm looking for? In regards to like women of color, it's a universal bronzer. Anyway, I just really hope that you guys don't lack. Just don't sleep on yourself. Because if you do, I've been sleeping for all this while. Motis Salah, I've been sleeping. That's why I did that. That product is so warm, so rich in color. Hey, guys, can you see my cheeks? Can you see this? This is contour down there, but this is warmth. This is Rihanna. She said, what's my name? Oh, na na kiloru kore. She said, what's your name, baby? And yeah, Eminem, so Jim Jones, how you doing? Nice to meet ya. I make myself what tired. So the next product that we have, guys, and I've even opened it and taken it out of the box before I've done the introduction, but the next product is the Fenty Beauty Pro Filter Instant Retouch Setting Powder in the shade Banana. This is the product, guys. Again, I have a thing for the Fenty Beauty packaging. Like, I'm not gonna lie, the packaging is mad. It says banana just there, guys, because everything else has just been literally cancelled out. But I think my favorite feature of this is that with a lot of setting powders, they've got the holes where the powder comes through. With the Fenty Beauty, what they've done is they've given you something just here. It's a separate part that becomes... It's a separate piece of plastic that then becomes a part of the setting powder. There's the FB logo, it's embedded, that's what the powder comes through. So you use this to close it, so it's literally a lid before the lid. So if I do this, nothing comes out. And this is open, by the way, this is what I used today. Epic, as in, can't lie, guys, like, I've had love for Auntie Laura for a while. And even before Auntie Laura was on the scene, I was one of those stupid girls that would say, yeah, Ben Nye forever. Yeah, dead that, bro. Ben Nye, bare chalky, bare hard, bare thick. Sister Rihanna came, and guys, she's stolen the show. It's until I try Laura Mercier powder in Honey for me to be able to give my final judgment. But at the moment, Rihanna's top two, and she's not two. And I know in the other video I said, oh yeah, it's, what's the big... I'm sick. I literally said, oh yeah, they're both top two. I don't know who's number one now. I can't lie. I'm just looking at my makeup. Rihanna's actually number one. I'm so sorry. I also picked up the Fenty Beauty Pro Filter Soft Matte Longwear Foundation in the shade 430. Now, this foundation, have I tried it yet? No. Am I gonna try it? Yes. Am I excited to try it? Very. Because the reviews on this... There have been some really, really good reviews, but there have also been some very much, yeah. I feel like it's one of those ones where it's either you like it or you don't. It comes with a pump attached to the bottle. Again, it's a matte feel bottle with a gloss lid, and you get 30 milliliters, which isn't that bad. It's a good amount. It's a good amount. It is soft matte longwear foundation. It's medium to full coverage, longwear, light as air. So it doesn't say anything about being oil free, but I'm guessing because it's medium to full coverage and it is a mattifying foundation, I'm just gonna guess on their behalf that it's oil free. And if it's not, well, in the spirit of still talking about foundations, I picked up this foundation. I actually got a sample of it before I picked it up, and I'm quite happy that I got a sample because I'd heard so many reviews and a lot of people were just like, yeah, it's amazing. Some people were just like, it's crap. So I wanted to make sure that this weren't going to dupe me, basically. I needed to make sure that you got it fair for me, because more fair than that, like, all my makes sense. Like, I don't want partiality. I don't want some time-ish foundation. And buying a foundation, you need to work for me. Even when I don't want to work for me, you need to work for me. What? Wisdom. So literally, I picked up the NARS All Day Luminous Weightless Foundation in the shade Dark 3 Benares. NARS has been around for a while, and I know that people have been using NARS for a while. Shout out to my auntie, Jackie Aino. Oh my god, her surname is Aino. Anyway, sorry. I had a moment. I picked up this foundation because I know a lot of people who had been using this foundation and they have nothing but good things to say. I think I've only met one person who hasn't really been a fan, and she's a bit of a weirdo anyway, so it's all right. It's not a problem. No, I'm joking, it's actually my sister. It comes in a matte bottle again. I don't know what it is with these brands and matte bottles. I've just realized. But they love a bit of a matte bottle. And this one's actually got a matte lid as well. This one actually says semi-matte. I didn't realize that. It says semi-matte on the bottle, not on the packaging. But yeah, I can't wait to use this because every review, aside from the one, everybody's loved it. And it comes in different types for different skin types. So I got the All Day Luminous because I have oily skin. I have the oily skin, guys. So I needed to make sure that I was gonna get something to make sense. If it didn't make sense, why am I buying it? Why am I wasting money? And we're not in the business of doing that anyway. So with the foundation, I also picked up the Radiant Creamy Concealer in the shade Medium Dark Walnut. And this is the Rich. Guys, there are rich concealers and there's this. This is so rich in colour that I just feel like they took a yellow marker and just pulled the ink into the mixture and then just made the formula. And I don't mean bad yellow, I mean really, really nice yellow. Like the kind of yellow that I'm thinking, all my life, where have you been? I'm thinking where you've been. Like, I'm thinking that, like, why have you been so far away? It comes in a normal tube with a screw top and a brush applicator as well. This is what I used to highlight underneath my brows. I even want to be using it gingerly. Like, I don't want to be doing like, I know there's gonna be a day where I have to, but if I can run away from that day, because this concealer, like, the consistency and the texture is gorgeous, like, literally. And it's not too thick, it's not drying, it literally sits on your skin when you're ready to blend it out. It's like, oh, we're ready, let's go. It doesn't kokimbe, like, it's not too forward. Also, while I was in Nars, a really, really nice lady who served me, she gave me a sample of the Climax Extreme Volume Mascara. Yeah, I guess this mascara is the shit. No, sorry. This mascara is lit. The reason why I say that is because this is what I use to prep my lashes before I put on these falsies. And I had, by the first stroke, I couldn't believe it. I'm telling you, I could not believe what I had come across. You know, with that new mascara feeling anyway, where it's like the brush is just soaked in product. It's just wet. It's what we need. Bloody well what we need. I was ecstatic to be able to pick that up. I can't lie to you. Moving on swiftly, sorry guys, I'm trying to have a whole bunch of stuff out already because every single time going into the beach bag is dead. I then picked up two brow products. I picked up these brow products because I feel like the whole world is now a benefit brow world. And I feel a little bit left out. I can't lie. Don't get it wrong, I am comfy on my wands with my powder. Don't ever get twisted. But me too, I want to know what all the hype is about. And I can't lie, well done Benefit, like, well done you lot. I picked up the 24-hour brow setter, which is a shaping and setting gel. So it's literally this really small mascara one. Oh, by the way, I got these brow products in mini sizes, and the reason why I got them in mini is because I didn't want to come and spend basically £23-24 on a full size product that I don't like. That to me doesn't make sense. And the minis are on 3 for 2. I can't lie to you, I'm happy that I picked it up. Regardless, I'm happy that I picked it up, but I'm happy that I picked it up in a mini, because if I had gone to spend that amount on, obviously the full size one is, I'm not sure how much bigger it is in comparison to this, but it's bigger than this, and this will last me for a very, very long time. I'm not really an eyebrow setter type person. Obviously, with the fact that I've got this now, it might change, but it's like my eyebrows, on a normal day, they don't move, but obviously that's with me using powder. But where I use the precisely my brow pencil, I kind of expected that there might be a little bit of a difference. So just to be on the safe side, I got the gel. And they also have a product called Gimme Brow, which is basically another form of a gel, but it's got color to it. And I didn't want my eyebrows to be too heavy or too dark. Like I'm not bushy brow comedy. Like I'm do my brows with my brow lady or with my hair removal cream and be happy and be overjoyed. I like clean defined brows, not brows that look like. Anyway, guys, don't come for me, please. Don't come for me. I'm not even on it. It's been a long day, I'm not on it. I also picked up the Precisely My Brow Pencil, which is this product just here. So again, this is the mini, so this isn't the full size one. The difference that I believe this has is that on the full size one, it's got a spoolie on the end, so you can use the spoolie to brush up your eyebrow hairs if you want to, but I've got countless amount of spoolies at home. I didn't really feel like I missed out too much. And this again was on the 3 for 2 offer. And because this is the first time I've used it, I wanted to try it. So it just didn't make sense for me to get it. It is a twist up pencil, so I can twist it up and twist it down and then literally just use the lid and it locks away. I see why we are living in the benefit brow world, because this product is amazing. I was saying earlier that I don't like eyebrow products that are too soft. I feel like if it's too soft, as the day goes by, it's just gonna wipe off, it's just not gonna be where you want it to be, it's just not gonna sit properly and all of that kind of stuff. And then there are eyebrow products that are too waxy. I mean, in the sense that before you put it on, you have to keep drawing, and then by the time you realize it, especially because I put foundation on first, by the time I would have realized it, the foundation from that area would have gone and I'm just drawing onto my skin instead of on top of the base that I've put, which is not what I wanted. So with this one, it's the perfect combination of a soft-ish pencil that isn't too hard and isn't too waxy. So it's got enough wax and it's soft enough for it to be able to glide on my skin really, really easily. And bearing in mind, it glides on top of a layer of foundation and a layer of concealer, because I do my foundation and concealer before I do my eyebrows. So I was pleasantly surprised, not gonna lie. Pleasantly surprised. And the third benefit product I got was the They're Real mini mascara. I've used this in the past and I can't lie to you, it legit is, it's the one. It's the brush for me. It's the brush. I don't really like full-size mascaras, I'm not gonna lie to you. I just feel like, not that they're a waste of space, but minis are a lot easier to bear with, they're a lot easier to use, I can carry them around. Yeah, all of that good stuff. Moving on swiftly, I picked up another 2 concealers, and I picked these 2 up because I've already used them in, so I've used the product before, I've just used it in a different shade. So it is the Fit Me Maybelline New York concealer in the shade 50. My current one that I've got at the moment is this one in the shade 40, and this is in the shade 50. So I don't know if you guys can see, but they are different shades. This one's lighter and this one's darker. So I've been looking for shade 50 for ages, because I saw some American YouTubers use it and it was quite close to the NARS Radiant Creamy Concealer in terms of shade. In terms of actual consistency, they are quite different. I would say that the Radiant Creamy Concealer is actually a lot creamier than the Fit Me Maybelline. They are, what am I trying to say? Basically, NARS is creamier than the Radiant. No, NARS is the Radiant. NARS is creamier than the Fit Me. Simple. They are both still really, really nice products. I actually do really like the Fit Me for a drugstore product. I'm not gonna lie. Like, don't let me lie to you. I actually do like it. But the NARS, you can tell, should be its NARS. Exactly. And then I also picked up the Infallible More Than Concealer in the shade 340 Chestnut. And as you guys would have known, because I use it in basically every video, I already have that in the 336 Toffee. So if you guys can see the difference, this is the new one, this is the old one, this is the lighter one, this is the darker one. So yeah, we love those products. They're staples, they're drugstore brands. So I can't lie to you, the fact that they're drugstore and they're staples. When I'm moving over to Kiko. So from Kiko, I picked up one of their full coverage concealers in the shade number 7. And guys, I can't lie to you, this is the packaging that it came in, a small little cute box. Kiko's packaging is always really, really cute. It comes in matte compact like that. You've got a mirror and then you've got the concealer. This is what I used just at the beginning of my eyebrows today and absolutely loved it. The consistency is creamy as hell. Jesus, So creamy, so nice, so lush. Honestly, I mixed it in with a little bit of my Too Faced foundation. Anyway, I don't know what to say again, because anyway, guys, anyway, like, I can't lie to you, as I'm thinking about taking this makeup off, I'm looking forward to the next time I'm gonna put makeup on. And that's coming from someone who I haven't consistently worn makeup in the last few years. I just don't do it anymore. Before, I would wear makeup every day. Now, don't do it anymore. Don't care. But with this makeup, I'm gonna have fun. When I say playtime, playtime. Moving on, I picked up something that's a bit different for me. Everybody, if you know me, I'm the queen of English. I'm the queen of matte face, matte base, matte highlight. I don't even highlight. Matte contour, matte highlight under eye, matte lips. But I just thought, since you need to grow up, like, I actually had that conversation with myself and said, baby, you need to grow up. You really, really do. So I picked up this lip gloss duo. This is the Unlimited Double Touch Liquid Lip Color, which comes in this packaging here. So you've got two sides. You've got the base color. So this side is number one and this is number two. So you put the base color on first and then you put the gloss on top. I haven't actually tried it, but I've seen really, really good reviews. I can't lie, guys. Kiko for their lip glosses, the best. Like, even before I used lip gloss, that didn't make any sense. Even before, when I never really used gloss, I had one Kiko one that I've still got, but they've discontinued it. The best lip gloss, because it's the correct shade of nude, it's a brown nude, and it's not too overbearing, it wasn't nasty, it was what I needed in the gloss, basically. And yeah, I just appreciate it for doing its job accordingly. I also got two more lip glosses. Two more, yeah, I know. I'm even gobsmacked. I got the Kiko 3D Hydra Lip Gloss in the colors 18 and 19. So this is number 18. This one over here, this is number 19, this one over here. Number 19 happens to be what I have on my lips at the moment. And guys, I can't lie to you, I'm doing wet lips to the world. One thing I will say is that I'm not a fan of this smell. Like, I thought it was just me when I initially opened it. I don't think I like the smell. I don't know if it's all of them or if it's just that one that I've used. No, it's all of them. I don't like the smell. It smells like, it's got a whiff of cod liver oil. And my mum always used to give that to us growing up. That smell isn't nice. But the product itself, coming from somebody who doesn't like gloss, I absolutely love this gloss. I'm not gonna lie. Guys, I'm coming to the end of the makeup list. Already? Sis, already? Oh my god, I literally am. It's called the Sicilian Notes Full Coverage Hydra Foundation. So this is a launch that Kiko did that basically it focused on a lot of hydrating products. As you guys can see on the packaging, you've got fruit, and the lady who I was speaking to was talking about the main focus and the main goal was to promote hydration within makeup. So within this one, it comes with a small little cute brush. You can literally just dip it straight in to the foundation pot. If you ask me as to why I got this, I couldn't tell you, but I was really, really intrigued as she was explaining it to me. Obviously, this isn't my typical type of makeup, but I did pick it up because I did want to try it. I have used Kiko foundation in the past and I actually really do like it. The color is really, really gorgeous. I would definitely be using this. I don't know how I'm going to use it at the moment. As to whether I'm going to use it as a full face foundation, I don't know. It might be something that I mix in just to use under my brows, or I might just add it to my makeup kit. You know, that's that. Last but not least has to be my setting spray. So I wanted to try really, really badly the Morphe setting spray mist, but they were out of stock when I went in store. So I just picked up what I know and what I'm used to and what works for me, which is the Maybelline New York Lasting Fix setting spray. This, guys, is just life in a bottle. Like, the day, I don't want to say days because I don't want to make it plural, but the days where I do my makeup and I don't put setting spray on, guys, I'm telling you, there's a difference. Like, you can feel your face do, and for the price, it just doesn't make sense. It's not even up to £10 from what I remember, but it is amazing. amazing. Say it after me. Amazing. I just wish you guys could see the chemical reaction that happens when I spray it on my face, basically. That's all I wish you guys could see. Literally, it is a matte finish. So it's none of that dewy, glossy crap. I don't want to hear it. You lot that love dew, that love gloss. I'm not here for that. I'm so sorry. I'm not even sorry. I'm sorry that I lied, because I'm not sorry. But overall, you've got... Oh! Do you know how much I love that spray? Damn, guys, that's everything that I picked up makeup wise. I'm definitely splitting this video into two, because it's just going to be irresponsible for me to do it all as one, because it will literally be an hour, and I don't think you guys are going to sit down and watch me for an hour, because I want to sit down and watch me. No, I would sit down and watch me for an hour. Sorry, I lied. Why would I lie? Why? Thank you for watching the first half of this video, guys. Let me know if you've tried any of these products. Let me know what you think. Let me know what your thoughts are. Let me know how they worked for you. Some of the products that I said are 10 out of 10, I know that for other people they might not be. So if they aren't, let me know what you thought of them, how they worked for you, if they did, if they didn't. And also, please, guys, let me know if you have any more makeup suggestions. I'm in the mood to try new products. I really, really am. I'm not going to lie. So if you do have anything new, let me know what they are and I will give them a try, and I will definitely review them as well. But yeah, guys, this was fun. I might do a few more hauls. As always, guys, blessings, love and light. Thank you so much for watching this video. Remember to like, comment, share and subscribe. Make sure you share this one, because you know it could be someone who needs a few makeup tips or a few ideas or new products to get, and they don't know what to get. So yeah, guys, I would say that you should share it with them. But honestly, thank you so much for watching. I appreciate it always. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye. Bye. To Atu. Peace. Atu. Yeah, bye, guys. San Francisco, Jami. When you won't want me, when you won't want me. I just flew in from Miami. Peru, Peru, Peru.